Hello children, good morning. I am your Hatasvi teacher from St. Thomas School. Today we are going to learn our SS subject. We were learning our unit number 2, Journey from Primitive Man to Settled Life. Some of the topics we have seen in previous video and some of the topics we will see in this video. Today's our first topic is Map of Stone Age Human Habitation in India. This is the map of Stone Age Human Habitation in India. Look carefully at the places marked in map. You have to look the map properly. You will find that at many places of India, the primitive man might have lived. See, dear children, in this corner some signs are given. First is Paleolithic place, means the primitive man place. In map you can see the many mark is like triangle in red color. It is here, means Kurnool caves. Then here near Bhimbetka. From this we can know that there are many places where primitive man have lived. Few places are shown in map, but there are evidence of their habitat in many places in India. They preferred to stay in good and large places where stones, woods and water were found. Primitive men used to live in good and large places where stones, wood and water are easily available. They lived in natural caves to protect themselves from rain and wild animals. They live in natural caves means they do not build their own caves where the caves are already available or are already built. They live there to protect themselves from rain and wild animals. Several such places have been found in Vindhya Mountains in central India. You can underline this. Such places have been found in Vindhya Mountains in central India. Such type of places have also been found in the region around Narmada rivers. These places are also found near Narmada rivers. Means the region around Narmada rivers. Bhimbetka has been found, which was an excellent place of human habitation. You can underline this. Bhimbetka, which is in Madhya Pradesh, has been found, which was the good place for human habitation. In its caves, near about 5,000 images of birds, deer, wooden spear, bur, trees and humans, etc., drawn by primitive man have been found, which are drawn with the help of natural colors. Means in the cave, in that caves, near about, the historians got near about 500 images of human, birds, then deer, then spear, animal spears, trees, etc., drawn by the primitive man with the help of natural colors. Here is the picture of cave of Bhimbetka. Now our next topic is discovery of fire and wheel and their uses. Ruins of ashes found in the caves of primitive man in Kurnool in South India indicate that they were familiar with fires. Means the ruins of ashes found in the cave of the primitive man in Kurnool in South India. This is the evidence that they were familiar with, means they know how to create fire. As per historian, approximately 11,000 years ago, humans started using fire. Means according to historians, approximately 11,000 years ago, the men were knowing how to make fire. Means before, approximately 11,000 years ago, people started using fire. Use of fire had revolutionized their life because with the help of it, they could cook the meat to eat, get light and protect themselves from wild animals. Means fire is one revolution in their life or in that centuries or in that years. The man can cook easily meat and eat them. Their people get light from the fire and they can protect themselves from the wild animals. Now discuss, even today, is it possible to think about our life without fire? Dear children, you can imagine your life without fire, or you can imagine that, is it possible today without our life without fire? Initially, discovery of will would have brought which changes in human life. You can also think that discovery of will would have brought what changes in the human life. Means after the discovery or after the invention of the will, what were the life of the people? Other than fire, will also revolutionized their life. After the fire, there was one revolution at that time, that is will. They learned to make will from tree trunk and thick wood. Means the people of that time started, they learned how to make will from tree trunk and thick wood. Now our next topic is changing environment. Around 12,000 years ago, there was a widespread change in the atmosphere of the world. Means before 12,000 years ago, there was a widespread change in the atmosphere of the world. Due to increase in temperature, vegetation and grass fields started growing in many areas of the world. Because of the temperature, vegetation and the grass fields started growing in many of the areas in the world. As a result, number of grass-eating animals, herbivores like deer, sheep, goat, etc. increased. Due to this, the animals, those who are eating grass, and that animals are called herbivores, like deer, sheep, goat, etc., increased in the world. Primitive man certainly got benefits of it. Due to this, primitive man got benefit. They started studying these animals' behavior and thus their mental development started. Means after this evolution, they started studying these animals and their mental behavior, and they developed their mentality. They came in contact with grass, trees, vegetation as well as wheat, barley and other grains due to climate change. Means after this climatic change, they come in the contact with grass, trees, vegetation as well as they know about wheat and barley and other many grains. By using stone, woman and man and children collected grains. Means with the help of stone, the woman, man and children collect grains. Because of this curious instinct, slowly agriculture started in India. After this, the agriculture slowly started in India. People started using stones to grow grains. Means people used stone to grow grains. They started growing grains near the bank of rivers and constructed their houses made up of mud, thatch, hay and other materials in nearby areas. Means people started growing the grains near the bank of rivers so that the water will be easily available, and they started living there by constructing their houses made up of mud, thatch means hay and other materials which is easily available near their areas. As a result for it, their nomadic life came to an end and started a settled life. After this evolution or after these changes, their nomadic life came to an end and they started using a settled life. The first companion or friend of his settled life was a dog. Dear children, we have studied in unit number 6 in old book about the primitive man or about Goma and Jomato. In that we have learned that their first companion or their first friend was a dog. Besides, he was also familiar with sheep, goat, cow, buffalo, pig, etc. They were also familiar with sheep, goat, cow, buffalo, pig, etc. Gradually, they started adjusting with them too. The people of that time started adjusting with these animals also. These animals protected them from wild animals. And these all animals protect the man's or a people's from wild animals. Thus, they associated with animal husbandry also along with farming. Now they are familiar with animal husbandry along with farming. However, research is being carried out to find out how long he had been using animals to get milk. Means research is going on that how long he had been using, means they had been using animals to get milk. Okay, dear children, rest of the unit we will see in our next video. Thank you.